This is the second part of the topic Laws of Logic. In the previous lecture, we learned about identity laws, domination laws, adiabatic laws, commutative laws, inverse laws, double negation laws, and De Morgan's laws. Now, today we are going to discuss these laws. The other laws are in first one, implication conversion law, then contrapositive law, then reductio ad absurdum law, associative laws, distributive laws. Okay, so this will be discussed today. Okay, so first one is implication conversion law. Implication conversion law is actually for any two propositions P and Q, for any two propositions P and Q, the implication conversion law is P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation P for Q. P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation P for Q. So this law can be proved by creating the truth table for negation P or Q and P implies Q. So to construct a truth table, we need the columns for P, Q, negation P, then P implies Q, and negation P or Q. Okay. So if you are choosing the pairs T, T for P and Q, that is T, 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 F, F, T, and F, F. So what will be negation P? The truth values for negation P will be F, this F, T, T. Okay. Now what about the truth value of P implies Q? So here we have P, this is so T implies T, that is T. Now this is T implies F, so T is true, then is P is true, then Q is false, so this is false. Then F, P implies Q means F implies T, that is here in the, in these two cases the P is false, so we have this is true, P implies Q, clearly true. Now what about negation P or Q? This is negation P and this is Q. So negation P or Q is T or F, and that is T. F or F is F. T or T is again T. F or T is again T. So the columns headed by P implies Q and negation P or Q are identical. So we can say that P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation P or Q. Okay, because the columns headed by P implies Q and negation P or Q are identical. From these two columns we can see that. Okay, next law is contrapositive law. Contrapositive law. That is, for any two propositions P and Q, we have P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation Q implies negation P. So this is the contrapositive law. P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation Q implies negation P. So to prove this, we need to construct the truth table. So the columns will be for P, Q, P implies Q, negation Q, negation P, negation Q implies negation P. Okay. So we can take, or we can choose the pairs of the truth values are 2 T T T F F T and F F. Okay, so we know P implies Q is nothing but T implies T, so T, T implies F, so F, so here is F, so T T. So negation Q will be having the truth values or truth table F T, this is Q, so F T, then F T, and for negation P we have the truth values from this F F then T T. Okay, so the truth value for negation Q implies negation P, negation Q implies negation P, that is here is F, so clearly it is true, here is true, then checking this it is F, so it is F, now here is F, so clearly it is true, then it is true, then checking this is also true, so this will be true. So the columns headed by P implies Q and a negation Q implies negation P is nothing but these are identical. So we can say that P implies Q is logically equivalent to negation Q implies negation P. So this is the contrapositive law. Okay, next law is reductio ad absurdum law. Reductio ad absurdum law. Okay, so reductio ad absurdum law is nothing but let F be a contradiction. F be a contradiction, and P and Q be any two propositions. Then this reductio ad absurdum law is nothing but P implies Q is logically equivalent to P and negation Q implies F. P implies Q is logically equivalent to P and negation Q implies F, where F is a contradiction. That means it's a compound proposition which is always false. Okay, that is its truth value is always false. F, that is, it's always false. Okay, so here to prove this, we need to construct the truth table. So the columns are P, Q, negation Q, then P implies Q, then P and negation Q, then for F, then P and negation Q implies F. Okay. So if we consider the pairs of truth values T, 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 F, F, T, and F, F, we have negation Q is nothing but F, T, F, T. Now P implies Q is nothing but P implies Q, that is here is T, here also F, here T, T. Okay. Now P and negation Q by this P and negation Q. T and F. So this is F, T and T. So T, F and F, it is F, F and T is also F. Okay, so this is P and negation Q. Now we know F has the truth value always F because F is a contradiction. So it is always false. So F, 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 F. Okay. Now what about this P and negation Q implies F? That is P and negation Q implies F. So F, here is F, so we can just write T here, T then F. So this is true, then F means it is false, so this is false. So here we have F and F, so simply we can write true, true. So if you check the columns headed by P implies Q and P and negation Q implies F, we have these two columns are identical. Okay, these two columns are identical. So we can say that this P implies Q is logically equivalent to P and negation Q implies F. That is the ratio ad absurdum law. Next law is associative laws. So for associative law, we need three propositions. So for any three propositions, P, Q, and R, we have two associative laws. One is P or Q or R is equal to or is logically equivalent to P or Q or R. And for a conjunction, we have P and Q and R is logically equivalent to P and Q and R. So here we can prove the first one, that is the law for associative law for conjunction, for a disjunction, and the second one you can do it yourself. Okay, so to prove this we can create a truth table. So the truth table contains, here we have three propositions P, Q, R. So the truth table will be of the columns P, Q, R, then P or Q, then Q or R, then these two. Okay, P or Q or R and P or Q or R. Okay, so the cases of truth values for P, Q, R. Here, since there are three propositions here, so the number of cases will be 8. That is, so 2 power 3. That is, we will have 8 cases. So, first case is T, T, T. That is, truth value for P is T, for Q is T, and for R is T. And second one is T, T, F. Then T, F, T. Then T, F, F. F, T, T. Then F, T, F. F, F, T. And last, F, F, F. Okay. So, by using this tables, we can find the truth values for these two propositions, compound propositions, and we need to check these two columns are identical. Okay. So, here P or Q. P or Q means these two. So, T or T, that is T. T or T again, that is T. Then T or F, that is T. T or F again, T. F or T, that is T. F or T again, so T. F or F, that is F. F or F is again F. Okay, this is the truth values for P or Q. Now what about Q or R? So this is Q and this is R. So T or T, this is T. T or F, T. F or T again T. F or F is F. T or T is T. T or F, T. F or T again T. And last F or F, that is F. So now we need only to check P or Q or R and P or Q or R. So P or Q or R. So this is P or Q. This one is P or Q or R is this. So we need to check this truth values for this. So P or Q or R is T or T, that is T. Now T or F, that is F. Sorry, T. T or T, that is T. T or F again T, T or T again T, T or F, it is T, F or T, that is T, and last F or F, it is F itself. Okay, so all the other are having truth values T. Now this P or Q or R, so this is P and Q or R is this. So by using this P or Q or R, we have T or T, this is T. T or T again T, then T or T again T, then this T or F, that is again T, then F or T, that's again T, then F or T again, F or T, so again T, then F or T again T, and last one is F or F, which is F. So from this two table, the columns headed by these two propositions are identical. So we can say that this P or Q or R is logically equivalent to P or Q or R. That is P or Q. This is P or Q or R is logically equivalent to P or Q or R. Okay. So this is the first associative law. Now the second associative law is for AND. So P and Q and R is logically equivalent to P and Q and R. So in a similar way of creating truth table, you can just prove that. Okay, you just prove it as a homework. The next law is distributive laws. So here for any three propositions P, Q and R, we have two distributive laws. One is P or Q and R is logically equivalent to P or Q and P or R, right? And the second one is P and Q or R is logically equivalent to P and Q or P and R. Okay, so the first one is the distribution of a disjunction over conjunction, and the second one is distribution of conjunction over disjunction. Okay. So here also we will prove the first one, and second one you can do as a homework, right? So to prove the first one, the truth table will be as follows. For P, Q, R, then Q and R for this Q and R, then for this compound proposition P or Q and R, then P or Q, then P or R, then P over Q and P over R. So here also, since there are three prepositions, simple prepositions here, so we have 8 cases as in the previous case. Okay, so here T, 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 etc. So these are the 8 cases. So what about Q and R? The truth values for Q and R. So this is Q, this is R. So taking this Q and R, we have T, T. So Q, T and T is T. T and F is F. F and T is F. F and F is F. T and T again T. T and F, it is F. F and T, F. F and F is also F. Now, next column is for P or Q and R. So this is Q and R and this is P. So P or Q and R. Okay, for these two columns. So T, that is P or Q and R. So T or T, that is T. Then T or F, that is T. T or F, T. T or F, again T. F or T, that is T. F or F is F. F or F again F, last F or F, F. Okay, now so this is the column for P or Q and R. Now the column for P or Q. So this is P, this is Q. So P or Q is T or T, which is T. T or T again T. Then T or F, that is T. T or F again T. F or T, T. F or T again T. F or F, it is F. F or F, F. Now similarly P or R. So this is P and this is R. So T or T, that is T. T or F, that is T. T or T, T. T or F again T. Then F or T again T. F or F is F. F or T again T. F or F is again F. Okay, so what about this P or Q and P or R? The truth table for this is nothing but this and this. Okay, this and this. Okay, so T and T, that is T. T and T again T. T and T. T and T. T and T again T. T and F, it is F. F and T, it is F. F and F is F. So our aim is to prove that this is logically equivalent to this. So checking the columns for these two, we have the columns headed by P or Q and R, and P or Q and P or R are identical. T, 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 F, F, F. Here also T, 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 F, F, F. So the columns headed by P or Q and R and P or Q and P or R are identical. So we have P or Q and R is logically equivalent to P or Q and P or R. So this disjunction is distributed over and, right, or conjunction. Okay, in a similar way you can prove the second one. P and Q or R is logically equivalent to P and Q or P and R.